this. The Bible says this. Because you're hearing me, but I don't think you're hearing me. He says this. He says this. Key word. I commanded a widow to feed you. But God hadn't talked to the widow yet. I feel like I need to teach. He said, I commanded a widow to feed you. And that would look like God had talked to the woman and told her that the prophet was coming. But God hadn't talked to the woman. He was going to talk to her through the mouth of the prophet. So who did he command? No, it wasn't the prophet. He said, I have commanded a widow to feed you. He hadn't talked to her. I'm slowing this down for a reason. She's looking at her circumstances. She's looking at the last scoop of flour, a handful of flour, and she's looking at a small jar of oil. The flour's in a big old bin. She's at her last. She has the last scoop of flour, and she has a last scoop of oil. She's going to put the two of them together and make a cake, eat it, and die. She goes out to the edge of the gate to gather up sticks to make a fire to come back and make the cake. But what she doesn't understand is that she is operating in a divine command of God, and she's operating in the divine timing of God. It's not coincidence that the prophet is there. He told the prophet to arise before she arose, and he told the prophet to go before she went. It's the same principle when Jesus said, I must need go through Samaria, because he knew when the woman was going to come out of the city and come to the well. So he went and met the woman where she was going to be. And see, what you got to understand, there is a prophetic declaration over your life before you even go through the circumstance. And you got to know God well enough that when you get to the point of need, he's going to meet you with everything you need. He has prophetically commanded. Now, here's what you got to understand, that in her circumstances, she sees flour and she sees oil that does not look like enough to sustain her. But what I want to submit to you is that he didn't command her, he commanded her circumstances, he commanded her resources, that before she heard the prophetic declaration, God had already spoke to the flour, God had already spoke to the oil, and even though it looked like to her it wasn't going to be enough, God had already commanded it, that it's not only going to feed her, it's going to feed my prophet, and it's going to feed your son. But the problem is, she hadn't heard prophetic instruction yet, so she was going by natural sight. But in between what she was experiencing naturally, she was going to come across a prophet who was going to speak to her prophetically about what God had already commanded. And some of y'all are sitting here like you're not catching what I'm saying. You're looking at paychecks and bills and houses and cars and jobs and children, and you don't understand that when you put that little mess together, it ain't enough. But you don't understand, he has already commanded in heavenly realms above your little stuff, and that all you need is some prophetic instruction on how to put it together. And when the prophetic instruction meets your little natural stuff, something supernatural is going to happen with the stuff that does not look like it's enough. He had commanded in heavenly realms, he had commanded more than enough. Prophetically, where there looked like there was nothing, he had commanded more than enough. Where everybody else was experiencing a drought, and the woman was thinking like everybody else, she's a widow, they're at the end of the line, and if Israel is under a drought, then certainly there's nothing left but for me and my son to die. Most people are trying to take care of themselves. They don't have enough to help us, so we can't go and ask nobody for nothing, because everybody's holding on to what they got. And so what she figured in her own reasoning, that this is the end of the line. This is the last, this is the end of my belief, the end of my faith. I ain't going no far. The last half act of faith is for me to go and gather some sticks. This is the last step before she goes too far. I feel like I need to preach this right here. It is the last step. I'm trying to teach you. Before she goes too far. She's going, can I teach? To get the sticks, to make a fire, to consume the flour and the oil to make a cake, and had she have done it, she was missing one ingredient. I'm taking my time so y'all can see the picture. If Elisha didn't come and she had done what she thought to do without prophetic instruction, it was the last step before she went too far. Because what she would have done is taken the last of the flour, the last of the oil, and the stick she gathered, made a cake, and everything would have been gone. But before she did that, he inserted the prophet and prophetic instruction, and the instruction activated something in the spirit realm. So the missing ingredient was the instruction. And so the Bible says that he had it with divine, he had him with divine timing, where he met the woman just as she was about to go too far. I feel like I need to. That's the beauty of God. And you got to be open to prophetic instruction, because when you got your mind made up that you're about to do something and you're about to go too far, it might be the point where he steps in and gives you the instruction that redirects you. And you got to be open to God and responsive to prophetic utterance and know when you're being spoken to prophetically that stops you from going too far. And some of you have made your mind up, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to do that. But in the midst of you doing this and that, when you get to that, God says, now here's what I want you to do. And he sends you an instruction, and you got to be open enough, here it is, to stop what you're doing and do what you hear. Don't just do what you made up in your mind to do. Stop what you're doing. He tests her prophetically. He comes to her, and look at this, Matthew 10:41. The Bible says that he who gives my prophet a cup of cold water will receive a prophet's reward. He who gives my prophet a cup of cold water to drink will receive a prophet's reward. Now, this is a principle. These are principles that are in spirit realm. And so what happens is he gives her an instruction that activates a principle based on how she responds to the instruction. He comes to her and he says, go get me a cup of water to drink. And the Bible says, as she was going. Now, you got to see what happened here. She came here to pick up sticks to go back and make a fire. But the prophet comes in the middle and said, before you go make the fire, go get me a cup of water to drink. And as she turns to go do what he said, it activates a principle, because even before she goes to get the water, the obedience activates a principle of a reward. And some of you, you'll sit here and you hear spiritual principles that are being spoken to you, but you don't activate your faith and you don't decide to go do what the Lord told you to do. And you sit there and you want to wait till God shows himself, but the principle can't be activated until your obedience and your faith is activated. She obeyed the word, and when she obeyed the word, it activated a principle of reward. Even though she was about to die, she was willing to give him water first. See, y'all ain't hearing what I'm trying to teach you. Oh, you're going to catch it in a minute. And because she was still open and willing to prophetic instruction, the reward of this is the prophet's reward. What is the prophet's reward? What is the prophet's reward? Prophet's reward is that there is no way that Elijah was going to serve God, speak for God, be a mouthpiece for God, and God would not preserve him and keep him. There is no way he was going to prophesy for God to a nation and God would allow him to be destroyed. And so the same preservation that was over Elijah's life was now going to be over the woman's life. And so by her just going to get something as simple as a cup of water, she is now swept into the prophet's reward, the prophet's preservation. And so even before she even goes to get it, she has now activated a principle that's going to keep her just by her response to the word. Can I teach? Follow this. The Bible says this. He stops her before she goes to get the water. Stay with me. And says, and by the way, bring me a morsel of bread. And then she begins to declare her circumstances in a prophetic atmosphere. And she gets a prophetic solution to her circumstances because she was willing to declare her circumstances in a prophetic atmosphere. I feel like I need to say this again. She gets the answer to her problem because she was willing to declare her problem in a prophetic atmosphere. And when she declared her problem in a prophetic atmosphere, she got a prophetic solution. Let me come back to this side of the room because I don't think they caught it. She was willing to declare her problem in a prophetic atmosphere. And so as a result, she got a prophetic solution to her problem. Let me say it to this group. She was willing to declare her problem in a prophetic atmosphere. So therefore, she got a prophetic solution to her problem. Let me say it to this group. She was willing to prepare to declare her problem in a prophetic atmosphere. Therefore, she got a prophetic solution in the prophetic atmosphere. One more time. She was willing to declare her problem in a prophetic atmosphere. Therefore, she got a prophetic solution in the prophetic atmosphere. I feel like somebody's going to get this. See, you came in here stuck up trying to hide your situation, trying to pretend like you don't have a problem and not responsive to what God is saying. But when given the opportunity, you got to be willing and not prideful to speak the truth about what's going on in your life. And you're coming into a prophetic atmosphere with a real problem that you're trying to mask and hide. Look at the woman. Let me help you with the woman, because some of y'all don't see the woman, and you're stuck up and you're stuck on yourself, and you want to portray an image. And the woman did not do that because she was desperately aware of her situation. Some of you aren't desperately aware, and you don't understand the significance of where you are. He tells the woman, go get me a drink of water. She doesn't say anything. She goes to get the drink of water. And oh, by the way, bring me a morsel of food. She stops and says, hold up. Now you went too far. I don't have nothing but a hand scoop of bread. I ain't got nothing but a little oil. Matter of fact, I was picking up these sticks to make me a fire, make my last cake. She told the whole thing. Then I was going to go back home, eat the cake with my child, and die. See, he asked her all that. She told everything in a prophetic atmosphere. You know what I love about it? Elijah didn't freak out. He didn't wig out. He said, cool. Go ahead and do what you were going to do. Just bring me something to eat before you do it. I feel like somebody's gonna catch the. Go ahead on with your plan, but just insert this prophetic instruction in the middle of it.